Hello and greetings from Iceland, but today is a big day, Saturday, September 18th. Officially, the day when the Geldingadalir eruption ended, leaving us with this lava field that is officially called Hveragerðisraun. But the rules here in Iceland stipulate that an eruption ends exactly 3 months after the last fire was seen, and that is today. And for that sake, I decided to offer you to join me in the time machine and see how the eruption developed and my channel beside it. And later on, I'm going to speak about where I'm taking my channel from here. But the story starts in January, and the timing wasn't good for me personally. And the lack of equipment was also a problem. So early on, I decided to make up for that with good maps in order to show you the bigger pictures, and that worked very well for me, since during the first weeks I was more or less stuck up north.
Whether we will have volcanic eruption or not, that's the question that all Icelanders are asking these days. So here is some data from scientists and others who think they have some idea about what's going on, including me.
Greetings from Iceland, but this video is dedicated to those of you who are here mainly because of my geology content, but I suspect that many of you will be interested in what I'm going to say now. And to make it short, Iceland might be moving into very dangerous times due to a huge earthquake activity, more than we have ever seen before, but that is not the worst news. The worst news is that it is next door to the capital of Iceland, Reykjavik. And the Civil Protection Agency has built on scientific data, stated that they expect a volcanic eruption in Reykjanes Peninsula within few hours, and they are preparing. So this is big news. And so I'm not gonna go so far as to call it a false alarm. There was a reason to be careful and evacuate the region around Mount Keilir. And yesterday, the earthquakes started again. And then I mean the larger earthquakes. Last 2 weeks, but the earthquake activity seems to be topping now. First we had an earthquake around noon today, measuring around 5, and just over 2 o'clock we had another one, measuring 5.4, and that one could be felt all around the south coast, all around the west coast. It shook Reykjavik rather hard, and in the nearest towns, Vogar and Grindavik, things were flying from the shelves. And we got to see this photo today, showing how the crust has been pushed apart for like 20 centimeters there. 10 centimeters each way, and there is no doubt about it that lots is happening, but when it will come up, that is the biggest question, and the experts say that it is getting more and more likely that this will end up with an eruption. My friends and greetings from Iceland. I have big news. The potential volcanic eruption I've been talking about is no longer potential. It is real. An eruption has started in Mount Hveragerðisfjall in Iceland, only about 20-30 kilometers from the capital Reykjavik. It might be around 5 kilometers away from Grindavik and the Blue Lagoon, but at this moment we haven't got the exact location. Everything is on high alert, And it has been really hard to read the news here in Iceland because the internet is just almost not working. Everybody is checking. A live camera has now been set up. It is pointing at the place where the volcanic eruption started. This is a brief snapshot from it. And a unique chance for you to take a look at this event. Where Mount Hveragerðisfjall is erupting again after 6,000 years of rest. So this is big news. At this time point, I had to set myself free to move around. Set aside other projects, such as creating a seminar for the Icelandic market that I was working on and it's still on hold. Then I bought myself some more equipment, like a drone, and the quality of my work got better as the general interest in the volcano decreased. And finally, I got a paycheck from Google, but I can't say that I'm getting fat from it. It has only happened once that I got a paycheck that was close to average salaries here in Iceland after a full month's work. But I learned a lot. And even this was a kind of financial disaster for me, it was my decision from the beginning to take part in this for the long run, get new subscribers and such. And I did manage to make my channel into, I think it's one of the top 10 largest YouTube channels here in Iceland. But there aren't that many Icelandic YouTubers, in fact, into unknown territory. Just like I was one of the first Icelanders who had serious eBay business going on for years. So this chapter was all about to work on my drone skills, gather a lot of footage, and overall try to offer content that wasn't just about the footage, but more about the bigger picture. So I had good exercise putting maps together and such, and started to feel a bit better about myself behind the microphone. But the Geldingadalir volcano left me with a few options. It was either to skip it or jump in, and I don't regret it to have jumped in. Icelanders pick a new name for a new volcano, but many of you might remember the trouble that the international press had when Eyjafjallajökull erupted in 2010 and nobody could pronounce it.
It's Eyjafjallajökull.
Eyjavolek.
That's it?
It's a name so unpronounceable we can't even
Things have started to happen again after two slow weeks where we were only able to see slow moving lava. A new fissure has just opened up. That happened just this morning, April 5th, and so I got the idea to make a selfie from a video file with the glowing lava in the background. And in a way, I got more than I bargained for when this rock came down. And you can see here how it looked from an icon. But I want of course to say that I was at safe distance. There was a little slope there, so this was not as dangerous as it looked. Only warm and cozy. Just what I needed. And all periods come to an end. Many of the Icelandic channels that have been covering the eruption are either losing subscribers or at least dealing with a huge drop in view count. Me too. But in my case, as for subscribers, I started to work again on this series covering all towns and villages in Iceland. It was one of the first tasks that I did on my channel, but the drone footage changed everything, so I'm replacing the older videos, and it's a lot of work that awaits me. So I am seeing new subscribers jump aboard, making up for those who are jumping off the wagon, as I see them sometimes do when I'm uploading something else than geology content. But the geology section on my channel is my personal inspiration for the channel, but it's not a good way to make a living. So I have to make other content as well, with a wider appeal, because that's simply what I need for the long run, and it's all about the long run for me. And it would be very hard for me to do it with any other attitude because the technology has been teasing me lately. You have noticed that I'm upgrading to 4K. So despite all those problems that I can call in a way luxury problems, because I can only be happy that I have almost 27,000 subscribers. So I am very thankful for this period because it is a basis for what is to come. And I have mentioned it before that I want to be able to make full-length documentaries by time. So that is my goal. And to make a 10-15 minute mini documentary every week, everything from script to end product, it is of course the best practice that I can ask for. Plus that this vlog form allows me to do the mistakes that are necessary. Just keep in mind that I need the algorithms to work with me on YouTube and check out my recent content about Klevarvatn Lake and other stuff that I've been working on. Because even if it's not a volcano about to explode or erupting, it is Iceland as is, or what my channel is about. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.